Hi, welcome all of you once again to my class. My name is Jewel and I hope all are keeping fine. So today I am going to take the third lesson of Standard 5. I am dealing with ICSE syllabus Cordova publications. Please like, share and please subscribe to my channel if you like to hear my further chapters from this textbook. Now let's go to the lesson, the tree. A tree can live for many years. It sees many changes in the world but remains the same itself. So a tree can live for many years and a tree can see many changes in the world but the tree remains the same itself. A tree helps the world in many ways. So read and find out how. So in this lesson you are going to study how the tree helps the world in many ways. Let's go to the poem. O tree, so big and stout and strong, you have lived so very, very long. So the poet is saying, O tree, you are so big and stout. Stout means thick and strong. You have lived so very, very long. You have lived very, very long. 100 years or more. So the poet is saying the tree has lived 100 years or more than that. I am told, and yet you are not so very old. And yet the poet is saying that even though the tree has lived for 100 years or more, but yet the tree is not so very old. 100 secrets you could tell. So the poet is saying that a tree could tell hundreds of secrets. Secrets means something which is kept hidden is called secrets. So a poet says that a tree can tell hundreds of secrets of children whom you love so well. So the poet says that a tree can tell hundreds of secrets of children whom you love, of children whom you love so well, who came and sat beneath your shade or underneath your branches played. So in the second stanza the poet says that a tree can tell hundreds of secrets, that is something which is kept hidden, of children whom you loved so well. See, the children love to play in the tree. No, the children love to play. Who came and sat beneath your shade. So the children came and played. And they came and sat beneath the shade of the tree. Beneath means under the shade of the tree. Or underneath your branches and played. So children were coming there and playing under the shade of the tree. And they were playing underneath the branches of the trees. 100 birds have built their nest. Your leaves have softly kissed their breasts. Your branches seem to touch the sky, yet you were once as small as I. So in the third stanza, the poet says that 100 birds have built their nest on the trees. Hundreds of birds, they come and build their nest on the trees. Your leaves have softly kissed their breast. The leaves of the trees, they have softly kissed the breast. Your branches seems to touch the sky. See, the branches of the trees, it seems like it is going to touch the sky. The branches of the tree seems to touch the sky. Yet you were once as small as I. But once the tree was small as the poet. Na? Yet you were once as small as I. Someday when I have grown up too, I am coming back to visit you. See, what is the poet saying? Someday when I have grown up. See, someday when the poet have grown up. I am coming back to visit you. That is, the poet will come to visit the tree one day. When the poet have become a grown up child, the poet one day will come to visit the tree. And changed though other things will be. All the things in the world will be changed. Everything in the world will be changed. But I'll find the same dear friendly tree. But the poet says that even though everything in the world might change, the everything, but the tree will never change because I will find the same dear friendly tree. The poem was written by Garnet Engel. This is the name of the poet. Garnet Engel wrote the is the author. Garnet Engel. Now listen. O tree, so big and stout and strong, you have lived so very, very long, 100 years or more, I am told, and yet you are not so very old. 100 secrets you could tell of children whom you love so well, who came and sat beneath your shade or underneath your branches played. 100 birds have built their nest, your leaves have softly kissed their breasts, your branches seems to touch the sky, yet you were once as small as I. Someday when I have grown up too, I am coming back to visit you, and change though other things will be, I'll find the same dear friendly tree. This poem was written by Garnet Engel. So what is the summary of the poem? The poem here narrates the journey of a tree. A tree can live for many years. It witnesses many changes in the world and remains the same itself. It is big and stout. Children play around it, and when they become tired, they rest under it. Trees are the homes of many birds and animals. The poet says that everything changes with time, and when she will be a grown-up person, she will visit the tree because the tree will not be so old and it will remain the same. I hope you all understood the summary part of this poem. Please share this with your friends and relatives, and please read this poem, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and please read this lesson. Okay children, share this with your friends and relatives also. I'll meet you in the next class. Until then, bye.